next part of Design Center, and really probably the most exciting part, is that we can have fills for closed shapes. So if we notice down here, there's a button with a circle and a square. If we touch that, we'll see we have lots of different shapes to choose from. These are sort of the simple closed shapes. We have another tab with other closed shapes. And you see some of these would make nice appliques, the teddy bear, the gingerbread. Some of those are kind of cool. If we go to the next one, these are open shapes. So that means these will not fill unless we close them. They might have openings that would not allow themselves to be filled as easily, but they're very pretty. And we'll talk about the saved outlines in a minute. We can also choose the size of our embroidering area, which would mean which hoop we're going to use. I usually leave it on the largest on this machine. That's 10 5/8 by 16. Unless I'm trying to fill an area, maybe for a smaller hoop where I want to do a fill stitch. So for now, I'm just going to leave it on the biggest hoop, tell it OK. But let's go back and choose a square, just a simple thing. Now that's neat. We've got a square. I can change the outline shapes if I want for that square. Right now it's on candle wicking in black. I could change it to chain stitch in blue, just as we saw with the lines we drew. Okay, as soon as I touch that, that's changed it now to blue chain stitch. But the important thing now is I want to change what that's filled with. So I can go here to my fill stitch categories. You'll see I can change it to a satin stitch, a stippling stitch, where this button is for my fancy fills. Again, I do have another button here. If I don't want to have a fill, I can change it to no fill. But let's go see what our fancy fills look like. Now, on this machine, we have a total of 30 different fancy fills. We can fill any closed area with any of these choices. They give us some really beautiful, beautiful choices. Let's look at this one. Number 15, I tell it OK. And I'll hit purple because I love purple. I'm going to hit my paint bucket and touch inside the box. Okay, so we can see that's filled with that pattern, but when I go to the next screen, let's say I want to change some things. It automatically, as soon as it gets, gives it a second, it centers the pattern in my square, but I could make that bigger or smaller. If I want to see more of it, I can take that smaller. Give it just a second, it'll center up again. So that's beautiful. I can change the angle of that fill if I want. Let's change it to 30% and see how that looks. Neat. Okay, so that's making it a little more irregular. I can turn off the outline for that fill if I want. I've already got the outline for the shape I drew, but if I turn that off, it won't put another outline around the fill. Okay, and this one's kind of interesting. I can make it a random shift for that pattern so it doesn't look quite so uniform. So let's see what that does for us. Okay, I don't know if you can tell so much on the screen here. Let's zoom in a bit. But it's making that a little different. It's just shifting it a little bit so it doesn't look quite so uniform when we look at it. Another thing I can do, this tells it how I want it to be set in the square. I can change the offset. When it comes up by default, it'll center it. So I might want to change that. Maybe I want to scooch it up a little. I tell it OK to wait for it to redraw. And it's going to scooch it up a little bit into the square. Or I can change the left-right so that it's going to scooch it over a bit. Okay, so it really gives me a lot of control over my fills. Let's see what else we have here. We also have a paintbrush. And what that does, again, we can go back here. If I want to draw something freehand, I can choose satin stitch if I want. I can change the size of my brush, and I can change the shape of my brush. I can choose whether I want it to be a square or a circle. And when I come back out here, again, I could, let's see, what shall we draw? I could just draw a circle with my hand if I wanted to, and sort of draw that in. And anywhere that I put color is going to fill with whichever fill I chose. Right now it's satin, but I can change this. Let's make it into a, maybe a little flower, huh? wherever there's this reddish pink, it's going to fill that area with whichever fill characteristic I choose. I don't know that that's looking like much of a flower at the moment. But if you were more artistic than I am, you could draw sun, you could draw anything you can think of. Had a little girl came in the shop that drew a horse for us, just using her fingers, and it turned out beautiful. We stitched it out for her. Okay, well, you get the idea. I've got some breaks in there, but it's okay. I could play with that more and get those filled in if I wanted to. I could again write my name, and this time it's going to be a satin stitch that will be filled. Wherever I have space, it'll be filled. Now, I can choose. Maybe I want to stipple that. Let's change it to a blue stipple. If I choose my paint bucket and touch inside, now that's going to be a stippled space. If I want to change it, let's see here. Let's go to dots. I don't know that this will look so good, but we could try it. Let's use the paint bucket and touch the S. See, now that's going to be connected of dots. Now, it's not a very big area, so when we go to the next screen, let's see how that ends up looking. There we go. So you can see where I drew. Now it's a stippling pattern. This is our original square, and here's where I wrote my name. And again, the dots are just going to kind of fill in there and look like an irregular pattern at this point. We can also, let's say we've been working, and I can't remember which color purple I chose in which pattern for this square. If I choose my eyedropper and touch that, look, it puts the purple and the pattern that I had used, and maybe I want to do that to fill another area. Maybe I now want to use with that pattern and that purple touch here, and now it's going to change that to that same pattern. I could do it with any of these areas. Whoops. Now what I did there was touch outside the letter, because my hand is not very precise, and it filled the whole area in, but I can just do undo. And now I have my letters. So now if we go to the next screen, we can see what those look like. Okay, so now they're all being filled in with that same pattern or variations thereof. Here's a neat thing that you can do on the second screen. If I go to that pattern and touch the links here, it's going to choose everything on the screen. See all these red boxes that are filled with that pattern, and I can change them all at one time instead of having to go through and change individually. So I could change the size of the pattern all at once there. Take it down to the smallest. I have to give it a second to catch up. Okay, so now it made it all a really tiny fill there. And we can see even better, maybe if I change the color, I could leave it the same pattern, go to red. There we go. And now we've got the small pattern in red for all those areas that were the same. If I wanted to now select the S, which we didn't change to this pattern, I can just touch the S, and that puts my selection box around the S. And now I could change that maybe to a satin stitch. Okay, it just changes it right there. All right, so let's continue to look at some of the shapes that we can work with in Design Center. We've got our closed shapes. Now for quilters, you might want to choose a block. And the nice thing with that is we can change it to be any size quilt block we want. So maybe let's go up to an 8. And these buttons, that lets us go down proportionally or up proportionally. We're going to go up till we get to an 8-inch block. Okay. You might want to go just a nudge or two past the 8 so that we don't see white lines when we sew our seams. In case our seam's just a tad off, that will keep us from having any white space. We could also change this if we wanted to and make it just shorter. Okay. Or we could make it taller without changing the width. We're going to go back and have the same width. There we go. We could make it skinnier and keep our height the same. Okay, we'll go right back up. Whoops, went too far. excuse my sniffling, I've got a little bit of a cold today. We could also hit the reset button, and that would take us back to the original size of our square. Another thing you might want to know, these buttons down here are so that we can move it. Now we can move this square just with our finger if we want. So if you're not being real precise, you could move it wherever you want to. If you want to center it, you can always just hit that dot in the middle, takes it right back to center. And then let's say I want to move this up, but keep it centered horizontally. I can just touch the up arrow and it'll keep it in the center left and right, but move it up to the top. Okay. So let's tell it okay there. Now what makes this really kind of nifty is being able to combine shapes. So let's say we want to put a heart inside of our square. We can drag it on up there. We can resize it. Might want to go down a little bit. We could go back here. Let's look at some of these open shapes. I love the little lovebirds. Let's try those guys in the middle of the heart. Now they're way too big, no problem. We're just going to go down on our size. There we go. Okay. All right, so we've got our shapes on here, but we haven't done anything with the line properties or the fills, of course. So let's go to our line properties and think for just a minute. Probably don't want satin stitches for these line properties. That tends to be awfully heavy. Maybe for the outside of the square, I would just want a single stitch. So I'm going to change that to green. And the paint bucket here, just so that when I touch it, you can see that it changes color. See how that's green now? That way we know we've touched the line and it's got the new property. For the heart, let's see what we want to use. Maybe go to some of our fancy fills, fancy lines here. I'm going to go to the hearts again. And we'll change that to a red. Now when I use the paint bucket and touch the outside of my heart, even though we don't see it here, when we go to the next screen, we'll see that those have the hearts on the outside. And if I touch my lovebirds, I probably just want those to be maybe a triple stitch so they'll show up. So I'm going to choose blue and touch my lovebirds. Okay, and those are not, see all the lines are not connecting. So I'm going to need to touch all the different lines that make up the lovebird there. They have spaces. Okay. Did you hear that little knocking sound? That means I'm either going too fast or it's already been selected. In that case, that's what it was telling me. Hey, you've already touched that bird. You don't need to touch it there again. That's okay. All right, let's put a little something around the outside of the heart. Let's go to our fills and see what we like. I don't know, maybe the... I love this one. Let's try that one. And I'll do purple just so we can see the difference. I'll use my paint bucket. And I will touch inside there, okay? Now, let's see, do we want anything inside the heart? Maybe not. Let's see what that looks like. So you need to give it just a minute to catch up with us. It's now digitizing it from art into stitches. See how cute that is? I just love it. If we want to change the size of our little hearts around the heart, I can change it right here. Take it just a minute. Okay, that's cute. And I could also, I think I'll leave that alone. I could change the fill pattern here, but I like that very much the way it is. Now here's a couple things. I can touch the different parts of the shape that I might want to change. If I wanted to change the heart outline, let's see. There we go. When I touch that, see now it puts a selection box around it and it's showing me it's red and hearts. If I want to touch the outside of the square, it's getting the inside because it's showing me purple and the cross hatching. So if I'm not having luck touching the parts I want, if I just use these arrows, it'll scroll through the different parts of my design. There's my bird, but it's just the one bird. And if I'm going to change something, I probably want to change all the parts of the bird. So if I touch this link, now all the parts of the bird are selected. I could go ahead and change that to a different color, maybe a dark pink. And maybe I decided, let's see what it looks like, at least with a satin stitch. So I wait for it to catch up with me. There we go. Yeah, actually it's pretty nice with a satin stitch. Maybe I want to make that zigzag just a little shorter. Let's see what that looks like. Yeah, pretty good. And I could change the density. I think I'm going to leave it alone, but it does give me all the choices here that I would want to do. Now, if I like that design, which I pretty much do, I can save that to my memory. I push the memory button, and then I have the choice to save it on my machine or on my thumb drive, actually either of the thumb drive ports, the top one or the bottom one, where I can also plug in a mouse, or I can save it to an SD card if I want to insert that. I think I'm just going to save it to my memory, and I could bring that up later and stitch it out. Okay, so that shows you a little bit more about the shapes.